All right, I'm here with perhaps the best point guard in the state of Virginia, Quinton Morton-Robertson. What can you say? 41 points from him tonight. 32 in the first half. He wins another state championship. Q, how's it feel to get your third ring in 4 years and go out a state champ in your last year at Radford High?
You just can't picture any other way. Winning your last game is just very – you just can't explain it in any other words. Playing with these guys every day, hard practices on a Saturday morning, I mean, workouts before the season, I mean, just can't describe anything. I mean, I'm going to miss these guys a lot.
As you get time to reflect on it, are you going to think back now what you've accomplished and say, man, that was pretty special, but also go, man, we were probably just a couple plays away from having four rings in 4 years because you've only lost, what, one game last year is Gate City in that game, state quarters?
Coach Cormier always talks to Marcus Finley about from his freshman year if he thought he was going to win all of them. And I mean, after winning my first one, I thought we were going 4-for-4. We lost one my junior year to a very great Gate City team. But, I mean, yeah, I'll look back on it and just think that maybe I should have came out and played differently that game. But yeah. I mean, I'm just happy right now.
Sure. You kind of hit on it in the press conference, but sort of elaborate on it, that first Radford team never going undefeated. And I think since realignment took place in 2013-14 of all six divisions, you're the only team to go undefeated. What's that mean, and how hard was this to go undefeated and not have a slip-up?
None of this is easy. The game, the state championship game was not easy. Practices weren't easy. Any other regular season games, there were none of them were easy. I mean, we had a target on our back from the start of the season. I mean, we had to play hard. We did every time. We defended as hard as we could and got a blow. If you trust your bench, you're going to be fine. And that's what we did the whole year. Bray Moore, Doris World, guys like that just killed it the whole season.
You're how tall? 5'8"?
5'8".
What motivates you? Is it hearing said, oh, he can't play Division 1 because he's so small? What is it that makes you go out there and compete at this level consistently?
Yeah, I see a lot of small guys. I look up to Isaiah Thomas in the NBA. His hunger for the game, how hard he works on his game. I look at that. I look at a guard like Chris Likes from the University of Miami. A lot of bouncing. He's like 5'6".
In the ACC.
Yeah, just short guards. I mean, you just don't really get the opportunity anymore because it's a different era of basketball. And to play at a high level, I'm just blessed to play at a high level for next year.
You were a good player as a freshman on that team, I think, with Blake Burdick that won a title. How has your game changed? From watching from afar, not seeing you guys all the time, but watching film, seeing you here at the state tournament, it looks like your three-point shot has just become absolutely really good where it was early on. You were just trying to become a good three-point shooter. Is that fair? Or?
That's just gym time. Me and Cam Cormier compete every day in the gym. In the gym to who can hit the most shots, who can hit the most three-pointers. That just comes from me and Cam just in the gym all the time.
Gate City game in the semis, the East Rockingham game. How tough was it to have these games back-to-back, knowing what Gate City has with Zach? That fourth quarter you had with him going back and forth, and then tonight, I mean, those Twin Towers that had 32 in the first half, I mean, that was pretty unconscious.
Yeah. Playing a team like Gate City, they're very skilled. They're really, a really good team. They play hard. They have a lot of scores on their team, like Bradley Dean, Zach Irvin. Then turning around and have to play a team like East Rockingham, number 5 was really good. Number 22 could shoot the ball. 4 played extremely hard. 11 was really good off the dribble. I mean, we just have to be locked in. I think we worked really well.
Last one, thank you for your time. Was that the best groove you've been in to have that first half 32? And you literally finished up just 6 points away from the state championship scoring record. Was that the best groove you've been in?
It didn't feel too bad. Then the shots really felt good coming on fingers. And I was just happy that they went in. And like I said before, I knew if I missed them, I knew my teammates were going to get the rebound and put it back up and just keep me up. So opportunities to score.
Storybook ending, you get another state championship, 2,000 points for your career at Radford. Now you're going on to Radford University. You ain't got to go far from home for college. That program with Coach Jones, you're going to step right in for a guy in Travis Fields who's had some big moments. Yeah. Your thoughts on the next level and what you want to do there?
I'm really excited to look up to a guard like Travis Fields. He plays extremely hard. Getting in the gym with those guys, Travis Fields, Carly Jones. I just can't wait. I can't put that into words either. I'm just very excited to play there next year.
Well, virtuoso performance for the state champion, Quinton Morton-Robertson. Congrats. Go enjoy it.
Sure. Thank you.